everywhere I go on this road, high and low. Where I go with you. There's a city that calls me by name. There's a city that calls me by name. Yes, as I run this race, I am cheered by the saints. There's a city that calls me by name. There's a future that runs through my veins. There's a future that runs through my veins. And there's nothing on earth that can stand in the way. There's a future that runs through my veins. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. Oh, I won't be afraid, it's my hope, come what may. Where I go with you. Where I go with you. There's a spirit I cannot contain. There's a spirit I cannot contain. The same power that raised Jesus up from the grave. That same spirit I cannot contain. Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. I won't be afraid, it's my hope come what may. Where I go with you. Where I go with you.
Be so happy to see half your faces. And again, these services are 9:30 and 10:30, 30 minutes long, and we are on live streaming this to Facebook. Thank you for, I see some people on Facebook out there watching, and we have every intention to continue this streaming stuff forever. That's not going to go away. At some level, there will be streaming. So you'll be able to find us at some point. Some of it's live, some of it's recorded, but this service will probably be the live one just because we've done a whole lot of work to get it there. Couple of announcements. Tammy Fisher, who is our accompanist, pianist, at the traditional service, she is moving to Pennsylvania. Next Sunday is her last Sunday here. If you've enjoyed her playing, there's a couple ways to let her know. Send her a card, let her know. But also, we have a Wednesday service at noon that you can come to. That's the same restrictions and rules that we have for all of our services, but you're welcome to come to that service live. It'll also be streamed. Or Thursday at 10 a.m., where we film the traditional service for Sunday morning, you can come to that one live, and you'll have a chance to hear Tammy during the week if you'd like to be here for that, or to hear this sermon, or on Wednesday it's a different sermon. There's over the course of the week from this point forward until something else changes with the pandemic or it goes away, we have six services, four on Sunday morning, one on Wednesday, and one on Thursday. Please choose the one that's best for you or online. And again, it's a joy to see you here. And you look so much better than you have for the past couple of weeks, just pieces of paper taped to chairs. But a lot of you were sitting right in those same chairs. We tried to put you where you sat. And so what a beautiful thing. I think that's it. When Emily's up here, she'll make some announcements about children. We are in 2 Corinthians for the month of June, in 2 Corinthians 5, verses 6 through 17. Hear now the reading of God's holy word. So we are always of good courage. We know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are of good courage, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please Him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive good or evil according to what he has done in the body. Therefore, knowing the fear of the Lord will persuade men, but what we are is known to God, and I hope it is known also to your conscience. We are not commending ourselves to you again, but giving you cause to be proud of us, so that you may be able to answer those who pride themselves on a man's position and not on his heart. For if we are beside ourselves, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for you. For the love of Christ controls us, because we are convinced that one has died for all, therefore all have died. And he died for all, that those who might live no longer for themselves, but for him for their sake died and was raised. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once regarded Christ from a human point of view, we regard him thus no longer. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. May God's blessing be upon us. And may God protect us from the enemy that is constantly at work trying to steal God's word from us. It's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Blow up your TV, throw away your papers, move to the country, build you a home, have a lot of children, feed them all peaches. Try to find Jesus on your own. The last time we met in this place, on March the 15th, I finished that sermon by quoting from one of my spiritual muses, John Prine. So I figure what better way to start coming back than to bring a John Prine lyric with me. That's from a song called Spanish Pipe Dream. A lot of other cool parts of that song, but that was the one I thought was most appropriate for worship. But it also, not just to a point, John Prine died of COVID-19 about 2 months ago. So it's kind of fitting that he is remembered in such a way. But the lyrics are good, because they remind us about kind of where we've been over these past few months. If you're like me, there have been times that you've been so happy that you have a TV and a screen to watch. If you have children at home, it's even more helpful to have that screen there. But there have been a lot of times when you've heard stuff coming off the TV and people saying things that you've just wanted to blow up that TV. We've all thrown away our newspapers a long time ago, I think, because we can find all that stuff online. And we felt like we've been out separated, maybe out in the country, kind of on our own, trying to find Jesus. And we know just how hard that is to do alone, because we are a people that need to be together. We need to be together, and we are doing it. Then this is, from what I can tell from all the numbers out there, we're doing this now at the height of the pandemic, not at the beginning. This is, you know, the numbers are saying just a lot out there. And we need to be together so much, we're coming anyway to be here. We're doing it safely. We're doing it with some rules and some regulations. We're doing it some way so we can be here together. But we desperately need this. I can tell you that the first Sunday when I walked in here, I about broke down in tears when nobody was here. And driving in today, the same thing happened, just seeing cars overwhelmed with that. Because trying to find our faith on our own is a very difficult thing to do. We can devote ourselves, we can read devotions, we can read the Bible, but we need to share. In 2 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, 1 Peter, anything you read, you're going to find that God's people need to be together. And we have stretched ourselves over these months to be together, and we've been fortunate to have this thing called social media and the internet. What a wonderful blessing it has been, something that we make fun of and say how terrible it is and what awful things come from. We've been able to use it. But still, we want to be together. Just seeing your faces, it brings great joy. Just being here for a moment, just for 30 minutes, it gives us something to hold on to. And I believe that in Paul's letter to the Corinthians, his second, maybe his third letter, there's one that seems to have been lost in the middle there from people who are much smarter than me, that Paul is talking to the church and saying, look, we've had some disagreements, we've had some problems, you've misunderstood me, perhaps I misunderstood you, but here's what you need to know. Here's what you need to know. And he says, he uses the language about being at home or away. And he says, in those verses, the one that we sang of Kelly's song that she sang about, but it's a reminder in verses 1 through 5 that we live in a tent. We have a building from God, a house made with hands, eternal into heaven. That's verses 1. In verse 1, we live in a tent. We are a tent people. We are a people who are moving about. But even as we move about, we need to be together. And I know a lot about tents. I have all kinds of tents. I have one-man tents and two-man tents and five-man tents and three-man tents. And I have heavy tents and light tents. You get it. I have lots of different tents. But they're all temporary. They're temporary housing. And they help me to move from one place to another. And Paul, in writing to the church at Corinth, is reminding them that they live in a temporary shelter. But they need to be together in that temporary shelter, and they need to find God and find their understanding of Jesus in that temporary shelter. And that they can do that as, and I like, because what Paul said in 2 Corinthians, he says in verse 9, so whether you are at home, and I paraphrase, whether you're at home or not at home, whether you're at home or not at home, our goal is one thing. Our aim is to please God. Whether we're here together in this building right now, or we're at home watching on the internet, or whether when we leave this place and go back out into the world, whether we're at home or not at home, our goal is simple. Please God. Please God in all that we do. And one of the things that's been difficult for so many of us over these months is that we all have very specific and particular opinions about everything. And sometimes our opinions may actually get in the way of pleasing God. And one of the things I've been saying is that my responsibility is much bigger than my opinion. And I'll be happy to share with you any of my opinions at some point personally about all of this. And I'll be honest with you about what I think and don't think about it. But my responsibility is always greater than that, because my responsibility is not to get my opinion across, but to make sure that I'm pleasing God. And one of the things that happened, and we have red on the communion table today, and red's the color for Pentecost. We follow the church here, and red's the color for Pentecost. And that was 2 weeks ago. And Pat Jordan, who's our worship chair for the traditional service, asked me, he goes, well, what color are we using when we come back? Because last week was white, it was Trinity Sunday, and we're supposed to be green this week. And I said, I want red. And she goes, okay. And I said, but let me look and see if I can find a reason for us to use red. So I did, when I wanted to find a reason to do something, I went on to Google, right? Can I use red outside of Pentecost? And then there's a bunch of articles that came up, and I started reading them from sources that I really trusted, to trusted sources I would go to on the internet. And all of those trusted sources said exactly the same thing. Red is for Pentecost, and you should use it for ordination, and maybe for a revival. Maybe. But basically, it's ordinations and Pentecost. Though you saw the sign out there, Reverend Kirby is being ordained in a few weeks. We're very proud of her and the work that she's done. Yay! You'll get to watch that online, probably, when it comes up. But she's not being ordained today, so I couldn't use that. And it's not Pentecost. And so I looked more, and I started Googling more, because I didn't like those opinions. So I wanted to find an opinion that met with my opinion. And that's what we do. We have to go search down the opinion that meets with ours. And so about the fourth page of Google, I started to find some opinions that actually met with my opinion. I'm like, oh, that's good. You can use it for homecoming as well. Like, this kind of feels like a homecoming. So basically, I went and searched for an opinion to meet my own so that I could get what I wanted. And so we have red out here. I really should have just started at the beginning saying, I just want red because I want red and I'm the preacher and I can do whatever I want. That would actually make more sense than going through all this trouble. So we have red. And red is the color of Pentecost. And I want it red out here to remind us that the Spirit is at work in what we're doing. The Spirit is upon us, and we are a Pentecost people. We are a Pentecost people, and God is offering us something new. And I don't have to find an opinion to back up mine to be able to say that. I can pull the red out and say this because in the Scripture it says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old is past and the new has come. And we are doing something new today. Something that, again, that we never thought we'd have to do. One, we never thought we'd have to take 3 months off from being in person in worship or come back and I'm wearing a shield across my face so I don't spit on you. I mean, it's amazing how I can hardly see out of this now. It's crazy. It's a new thing. But it doesn't mean we can't do it. Whether we're at home or not at home, it's not about making my opinion right. It's about pleasing God. And that's what we'll do. That's what we'll do today, and that's what we'll do tomorrow. We will do what we have been called to do to please God. That is our aim. That is, it's all portable. It's all portable. We're all living in tents. Even this building, as nice and fancy as it is really just an elaborate tent. It really is just an elaborate tent. One day it won't be here. This is not permanent or forever. This is not God's house. God doesn't live here. This is the place where God's people come to worship. This is the house of God's people. God is not confined to this space. He is with us if we're at home, if we're here, if we're not at home. Wherever we are, God is with us. And it's our goal. It's our aim in all that we do to please God. To please God. And I am positive what we're doing today is pleasing to God. And I'm positive when we leave this place, we'll go out into the world to be pleased, do things that are pleasing to God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and all God's people said, amen. All right, let's see. Announcements, we did those. And just making sure we aren't missing anything. And y'all have not probably met Emily Kirby in person. She was hired right in the midst of all this. I hope you've seen her online. She is head of Children's, Youth, and Family Ministries. We've got a big play area back there. It's very exciting. We're going to keep that in here permanently, too. Probably going to move it up to the front here at some point. But it's good right there. So we do want children here. Emily will say a little bit more about the children's and family stuff and say our prayer for us also.
Yes, I told our 8:30 crowd, it's great to see we have congregation members. This is a great experience. A couple of very quick announcements, and I'm going to actually have to run out of here right after our prayer because we have an additional worship service that is for our River Kids. So anybody who's children and families, that service starts online at 10 o'clock. So if you're watching online, jump over to our Little River Kids and Family Ministries Facebook page, and we'll be online there at 10 o'clock. And then we also have children and families, a family-style Sunday school offering that's posted on that same Facebook page beginning on Fridays when the newsletter comes out that we have weekly. So if you want any extra information about that, all of my contact information is online. Please feel free to reach out, give us a call. I can answer any questions you have for that. So will you join me as we go to God together in prayer? Merciful and holy Lord, we are in awe of the ways that you have moved among us in this season. And Lord, we are acutely aware of your spirit among us today as we gather your children back together again. Lord, we know that whether we are here or whether we are still at home worshiping, we are your people. And as your people, we ask for an abundance poured out unto us of discernment, of hope, of joy, so that we may continue to love you and love others well, not only in this season, but until we are united with you again in eternity. And so, Lord, we lift up our voice, one church today, praying the prayer you taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who've trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And so good to see you. Run to our worship service.
All right. Yep. It's a busy, busy morning. After I give the benediction, the band will play. Again, we're going to ask that you leave the back door. If you are unable for varieties of reasons to walk across the dirt, just please stay seated until everybody's cleared the place, and then we'll actually, I mean, there are ways. We're not forcing you. If you can't handle it, that's okay. And but that'll just be very helpful to us. We've started a new tradition. I raise my hands to offer the benediction. I invite you to raise your hands to receive the same benediction. Lord, be with us. Whether we're at home or not at home, whether we're here or there, Lord, be with us as we go into the world to share the good news of Jesus Christ with a world in desperate need of good news. Go to love and to serve in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And all God's people said, Amen. So they're going to sing a little bit, and then the ushers will start to help you move out as we sing.
Sometimes I think, what would people say of me when I'm only just a memory, when I'm home where my soul was. I loved when no one else would show up? Was I Jesus to the least of us? Was my worship more than just a song? I wanna live like that.
like that.
I'm crying for the world to know the glory of the King. I want to live like that and give it all I have so that everything I say and do points to
before. That was cool.
All right.
Hey, Ron.